Good morning to all. Here, the topic that we can discuss today is oscillations, in which the first heading that we can cover is about equation of simple harmonic motion, phase, and comparing simple harmonic motion with uniform circular motion. In which the first question that we can cover is the equation of motion of a particle executing simple harmonic motion is a plus 16 pi square x equal to 0. In this equation, a is the linear acceleration in meters per second square of the particle at a displacement x in meter. The time period in simple harmonic motion is, here the first option given as a is 3 by 4 seconds, 1 by 2 seconds, 1 second, and 2 seconds. Out of these three, these four options, here to have an equation of acceleration of a particle executing simple harmonic motion, that we know that is a equal to minus omega square x. And corresponding to this equation, if we compare the equation which is given in the question, a plus 16 pi square x equal to 0, where a is acceleration, it is given in the question that a value can be taken it as a equal to minus 16 pi square x. If we compare that equation with the standard equation a equal to minus omega square x, then we can get the value of omega as 4 pi. And here the omega is the angular frequency or angular velocity in case of rotation motion as well as SHM. Here we can consider angular frequency. That angular frequency can be written as 2 pi nu. In the place of nu, we can substitute 1 over capital T. Therefore, we can have the value of omega as 2 pi by capital T, that is equal to 4 pi. And if we simplify, you will get the value of T as 1 by 2 seconds. That means the time period is half second. Next, question number 2. A particle executes simple harmonic motion between x equal to minus a to x equal to plus a. The time taken for it in going from O to A by 2, that O refers as the mean position, that O to A by 2, or you can consider this as a 0 to A by 2, is T subscript 1, that is T1, and from A by 2 to capital A is T subscript 2, that is T2. Then T1 less than T2 and T1 greater than T2, and T1 is equal to T2 and T1 is equal to 2T2, it is given, the question. According to theory, just we can have an idea that velocity of a particle executing simple harmonic motion is maximum at mean position and minimum or zero at extreme position. As the body traveling from mean position to extreme position, at a point extreme position, the velocity will be zero. As the velocity will be zero, the time taken will be the maximum that we can consider. Ultimately, according to the theoretical aspect that we can choose, here the T2 will be the larger one as compared to T1. Therefore, the option number A is the correct option. The next, question number 3, values of an acceleration capital A. In general, we can have the notation for the acceleration in simple harmonic motion is a small a, but in the question it is given it as a capital A of a particle moving in simple harmonic motion as a function of its displacement small x are given below. Here capital A means acceleration in millimeters per second square is provided, 16.8 0, minus 8, minus 16. And the displacement term x in millimeters is provided minus 4, minus 2, 0, 2 and 4. The period or the time period of motion is 1 by pi seconds and 2 by pi seconds, pi by 2 seconds and pi seconds. We know the standard equation of acceleration of a particle executing simple harmonic motion is a equal to minus omega square x, and here we have applied the magnitude, that means modulus, for the acceleration. If anything minus term is there, that we can eliminate out the modulus of a, and here the capital A is given in the question, therefore the modulus of a that we have written, that is equal to omega square x, which implies if we cross multiply this modulus of capital A divided by x will gives you omega square, and here the ratio of capital A to the x value will be 4. Anywhere you can divide, there will get value 4, and here omega value is equal to 2 radians per second, because omega square is 4 and omega is 2 radians per second. Therefore omega is equal to 2 pi by capital T, that we know the value. Here the capital T can be equated to 2 pi by omega, and 2 pi, omega value already we know, that is the 2 radians per second, and that can be equated to pi seconds. Therefore the correct option is pi seconds, that is option number D we can have. Next is the time taken by a particle performing simple harmonic motion on a straight line to pass from point capital A to capital B, where its velocities are same. That is 2 seconds. After another 2 seconds, it returns to the point B. The time period of oscillation is, that is in second, it is asking 2, 4, 6, and 8 seconds. Here, just we can go with the theory. In between the point A and B, if we choose, it means the exactly midpoint of the A and B, if we choose the reference point, or we can say the mean position of the particle executing simple harmonic motion, as the body tries to move from mean position to point B, it will take 1 second. And again, it is given in the question that after another 2 seconds, it returns back to the B. That means after crossing the particle, the point B, again, it will reach to its extreme position. It will come back within 2 seconds. And already it has covered 1 second from the mean position to reach the particle B. Again, from the particle, from the point B, the particle will reach its mean position. Means it has taken time to complete half of the oscillation as 4 seconds, and another half will give you the 4 seconds. Therefore we can choose the 8 second as the correct option for the given question. Next question is, a particle is performing simple harmonic motion along x-axis with amplitude 4 cm and time period 1.2 seconds. The minimum time taken by the particle to move from x equal to 2 cm to x equal to 4 cm and back again is given by 0.6 seconds, 0.4 seconds, 0.3 seconds and 0.2 seconds. Here in the question, we need to take care the minimum time taken by the particle to move from x equal to 2 cm to x equal to 4 cm. It is given. And the amplitude is 4 cm. Here to have an answer for this, just we can go with the calculation. The time taken by the particle to move from x equal to 0 to 4 cm. Here x equal to 0 to 4 cm means from the mean position to one of the extreme position, because the 4 centimeter it is given as amplitude, and we know that the amplitude is the maximum displacement from the mean position of the oscillation. Here the mean position as a reference point that we can take x equal to 0, and the extreme position is x equal to 4 centimeter. That means the amplitude. Therefore, the particle while executing simple harmonic motion to reach from the mean position to its extreme position, it will take t by 4 seconds, means 1/4 of the time period of the oscillation. Therefore, we can take it as t by 4. That can be equated to 1/2, because t value it is given, period value is given, 1/1.2 divided by, here it is 4, that is equal to 0.3 seconds. Let small t be the time taken by the particle to move from x equal to 0 to x equal to 2 seconds, because we want the value from x equal to 2 to x equal to 4 again coming back. For that purpose, here already we have calculated time taken for the particle to reach from mean position to extreme position is 0.3. Next, we are calculating time taken for the particle to reach from x equal to 0 to 2 centimeter. Therefore, the displacement equation, it means a standard equation of a simple harmonic motion where the initial phase is 0, that can be taken as y equal to a sine omega t, that is equal to 2. That means the y value we can substitute it as a 2 centimeter, and the capital A is the amplitude value, that is 4 centimeter, and sine of 2 pi by capital T, which is the value of omega. 2 pi by capital T is a value of omega, and multiplied by T, that T only we are calculating here. That means if you simplify, the 4 you can bring in the denominator of the LHS, there you will get 1/2, that is equal to sine 2 pi by capital T value, we can substitute 1.2, it is given in the question. Therefore, the T value you can calculate by using this, the half, that means the value of half will be taken it as a sine pi by 6 or sine 30. Because if you take this sine theta here in the right hand or left hand side, you will get sine inverse of 1/2, that is equal to omega T. Omega value already you have substituted. This sine inverse of 1/2, sine inverse of 1/2 is pi by 6, that is equal to 2 pi by 1.2 T. This implies T equal to 0.1 seconds. Therefore, time to move from x equal to 2 to x equal to 4 is, just you can subtract the value which you have calculated, the time taken for 1/4 of the oscillation, that is to reach from, to move from mean position to extreme position that you have calculated, that is a 0.3 minus here 0.1 second. That will give you 0.2 seconds. Now, here we want the time taken for the particle from x equal to 2 to x equal to 4 again coming back. Therefore, the total time to move from x equal to 2 to x equal to 4 and back again, that is equal to 2 times of 0.2, that is equal to 0.4 seconds. Therefore, here the option number B is the correct option that we can choose. Next one is two particles capital P and capital Q describes simple harmonic motion of same amplitude A, same frequency F along the same straight line. Here in the question, the amplitude notation is mentioned it as a small a. Okay. Here it doesn't mean that small a is acceleration. Here the amplitude is capital, amplitude is small a. In general, we can represent the amplitude as capital A in SHM. In the question, it is given as a small a. The maximum distance between the two particles is a root 2. the phase difference between the particles is, here it is option given 0, pi by 2, pi by 6 and pi by 3. Once again, we can concentrate on the statement which is given, the maximum distance between the two particles is a root 2. That means maximum path difference between the two particles is given. So with the help of this given data, we can try to produce the answer. Let us consider the particle is executing simple harmonic motion. Along x direction, that is x1 is equal to a sine omega t plus phi 1 and x equal to a sine omega t plus phi 2. Here this phi 1 and phi 2 are the initial phases of these two particles executing SHM. Now we can take the differences between these two, x1 minus x2 is equal to, here a sine omega t plus phi 1 plus a sine omega t plus phi 2. After the simplification, just you can give the you can use the formula sine c minus sine d formula. If you use the sine c minus sine d formula, you will get 2 sine c plus d cos c minus d by 2. Here once again I will tell you, here sine c minus sine d formula will be 2 sine c plus d by 2 and cos c minus d by 2. Using that mathematical relation, we can produce this step 2 a sine omega t plus phi 1 plus phi 2 divided by 2. Here in reality, omega t plus omega t by 2 it will come. Therefore, 2 omega t by 2 you can write. Therefore, omega t as it is. And the remaining term cos, here omega t plus 1 plus phi 1 minus omega t plus phi 2 divided by 2. Both the omega t will get cancelled. Phi 1 minus phi 2 divided by 2 remains. Now in the question, it is given the maximum displacement between the these two particles, that means the path difference. To become a maximum, one thing we should know, that the sine of, in the right hand side term, 2a sine omega t plus phi 1 plus phi 2 divided by 2 cos phi 1 minus phi 2 divided by 2, in that term sine omega t plus phi 1 plus phi 2 divided by 2 should be equated to 1, because we want the maximum path difference and it is given in the question. According to the question only we are moving here. Therefore, the maximum value of x1 minus x2, that means the path difference, is a square root of 2, can be equated to 2a into 1 into cos phi minus 2 divided by 2. This implies if you simplify this, you will get 1 by square root of 2 is equal to cos phi 1 minus phi 2 divided by 2. Therefore, the cos inverse of 1 by root 2 will be pi by 4, that is equal to phi 1 minus phi 2 divided by 2. Therefore, phi 1 minus phi 2 can be equated to pi by 2, we can get. Therefore, the phase difference between these two particles will be pi by 2. The option B is the correct option for the given question. The next question is question number 7. A particle executing simple harmonic motion of amplitude 4 cm and the time period capital T is equal to 4 seconds. The time taken by it to move from positive extreme position to half the amplitude. from positive extreme position to half the amplitude. It is given, and options are 1 second, 1 by 3 seconds, 2 by 3 seconds, and the square root of 3 by 2 seconds are given. Here in the question, it is given the time taken by it to move from positive extreme position to half the amplitude. At a time t equal to 0, the positive extreme position means the particle is at extreme position at time t equal to 0 that we can consider. This situation will be considered to be the cosine function. Okay, cosine function will be the maximum when theta value as 0. Therefore, we can choose here the function corresponding to, or the equation corresponding to, the particle executing simple harmonic motion as y equal to a cos omega t, which implies a by 2 can be equated to a cos omega t. This implies cos omega t can be equated to 1 by 2. That means both the a term we can make cancel. Thus, we can get cos omega t is equal to 1 by 2. And omega t can be equated to cos inverse of 1 by 2. That is, cos inverse of 1 by 2 is here 60. That means the angle 60 can be written as pi by 3. Therefore, 2 pi by capital T into small t can be equated to pi by 3. Therefore, t equal to pi by 3 into capital T divided by 2 pi equal to 4 divided by 3 into 2. That is 2 by 3 seconds. T equal to 2 by 3 seconds. Therefore, the option C is the correct option. Question number 8. A particle is moving in a circle with a uniform speed. Its motion is not periodic, periodic and SHM, periodic but not SHM, none of the above. It is given. The particle is moving in a circular motion. That means uniform circle. Here the motion is uniform speed. It is given in the question. The motion of a particle is in a circular manner and it is having uniform speed. This uniform speed means the particle is not having any kind of acceleration. If the particle is not having any acceleration, means it is not a simple harmonic motion. But the particle is moving with uniform circular motion. Circular motion can be a periodic motion that you have studied in the theory. And for the SHM definition, we can have the theoretical background. Whenever a particle is said to be execute simple harmonic motion, its acceleration must be always directed towards the mean position, and it is directly proportional to the mean position. Okay, you can use this concept to answer this. That means the particle can have a periodic motion, but since it is not having any kind of acceleration, therefore we can say this particle is not having simple harmonic motion. That means the option number C is the correct option. Next is the acceleration displacement graph of a particle executing simple harmonic motion is shown in the diagram. The time period of simple harmonic motion is, it is given 4 pi by square root of 3 seconds, 2 pi by square root of 3 seconds. The given graph does not represent simple harmonic motion and information is insufficient. It is given. Once again, we can focus on the diagram. Here, the acceleration versus here displacement is given. Acceleration versus displacement graph. In this, there is a straight line passing through the origin, and the angle 37 is already represented. Here, the angle 37 represented means we can extend the vertical line for this, which can use a negative tan theta. Okay, here the value of theta is 37 degrees. Just I can take the tan theta value as delta A to the delta X with a negative tan theta. Just I can write this as a delta means here dA by dx, that means differentiation of acceleration with respect to the displacement, that like that it is given, because tan theta means the ratio of opposite by adjacent, like that also we can take. This is dA by dx equal to minus of tan 37 degrees. And again, if we can plot the diagram minus of R tan 37 degrees, here the opposite side you will get 3 units and the adjacent side you will get the 4 units. Therefore, we can rewrite this as minus of tan 37 as 3 by 4. This implies the acceleration A can be equal to minus 3 by 4 x, because in the denominator part of x here dA by dx, because this tan 37 it is a larger value. The dA by dx means it is a small value of acceleration to the small value of displacement. And since the tan 37 is the larger value, that we can take dA can be replaced by A and dx can be replaced by X. A by X can be equated to minus 3 by 4. Therefore, A can be equated to minus 3 by 4 X we can take. And therefore, omega square X can be equated to 3 by 4 X. This omega square x term that I have taken for acceleration, because we know the standard value or standard equation for the acceleration is omega square x. If the particle executing simple harmonic motion along x direction, you can take here omega square x. If it is taking place along y direction, you can take it as omega square y. But our present case is about x. Therefore, we can take omega square x equal to 3 by 4 x, which implies omega square can be equated to 3 by 4. Both the x we can make cancel. Therefore, here omega square value we can write it as 2 pi by capital T whole square, and taking square root on both sides, you will get square root of 3 by 2, that can be equated to 2 pi by capital T. Thus, the capital T value you can take it as a 4 pi by square root of 3 seconds. Here the option number A is the correct option that we can choose. Next is question number 10. The particle is performing simple harmonic motion if its displacement from mean position is x. Corresponding resultant force on it is capital F and acceleration is A. Which of the following graph is correct graph? It is given. As we know that here the equation for the force, the linear equation, that means in the linear our translatory motion, we can give the expression for force as ma and minus m into omega square x. The term why we have taken it is the value of acceleration of a particle executing simple harmonic motion is minus omega square x. Therefore, we can take F equal to m as it is, we can keep, and here minus omega square x. And if we check all the graphs, okay, this equation represents a straight line equation. So here F equal to minus of m into omega square x. M omega square x, that we can take any slope like this, and x is a variable we can take. This represents a straight line graph with zero intercept. Okay, and remember here we can have the negative sign. Necessarily, out of these all four options, we can have the two options B and D. But remember, our equation represents minus m omega square. That means minus of some slope into x, which gives you the correct form of the correct option as the D option. That means the force versus displacement graph, which has a straight line with a negative slope. Therefore, the option D is the correct option that we can choose. The next is two simple harmonic motions are represented by the equations y1 equal to 4 sine 10 t plus 5, which implies y2 equal to 5 cos 10 t. What is the phase difference between their velocity? Here 5 minus 5, 5 plus 5 by 2, 5 minus 5 by 2 are these given. So we can take these two equations under consideration and related possibilities that we can take. Here y1 equal to a sine 10 t plus 5, and it is given as implies sign. That should be the and sign. And y2 equal to 5 cos 10 t. Here we can take these two equations, y1 is equal to 4 sine 10 t plus 5 and y2 equal to 5 cos 10 t. Now in the question it is asked about the velocities, the phase difference between their velocities it is asked. Therefore we can differentiate the displacement with respect to time. That means v1 can be equated to dy1 by dt will give you, that is 4 multiplied by 10, sine theta will be the cos theta, and it is a chain rule that we can take it as a cos of. Here in the place of omega we have 10, that 10 we should be multiply here. 4 multiplied by 10 cos 10 t plus 5. And the next v2 can be equated to dy2 by dt can be equated to. Here the differentiation of cos theta is minus sine theta, and since it is a chain rule, again we can apply in the place of omega we can have the 10, the 10 should be multiplied with the 5 with a negative sign, minus 5 multiplied by 10 sine 10 t. Therefore v2 can be equated to 50 cos 10 t plus 5 by 2. Here purposely I made some possibilities to make change for the v2, as the cos theta can be written as sine theta can be written as cos 90 plus theta, because the sine minus sine theta it is given, minus sine theta 50, if you take out minus sine theta remains, minus 10 sine 10 t can be written as cos of pi by 2 plus 10 t. And inside the bracket, I can rearrange the term 10t plus pi by 2. Therefore, v2 can be equated to 50 cos 10t plus pi by 2. Therefore, now the phase difference between v1 and v2, we can take here phase angles. Only the phase angles you can take 10t plus 5 minus of 10t minus pi by 2. The difference between their phases can be taken, and 5 minus 5 by 2, the answer you will get. Therefore, the correct option for the question is 5 minus 5 by 2. That is the option number D. The next is, a particle performs simple harmonic motion on x-axis with amplitude capital A and time period capital T. The time taken by the particle to travel a distance a by 5. starting from rest is here t divided by 20 t by 2 pi cos inverse of 4 by 5 t by 2 pi cos inverse of 1 by 5 t by 2 pi sin inverse of 1 by 5. Here in the question, time taken by the particle to travel a distance of a by 5. So we can have the diagram for this. The particle is starting from the rest, that is from one of its extreme position. It is clearly mentioned in the question itself, one of its extreme position. As particle move a distance, we can represent it on a circle. Here the diagram, in the diagram we can take like this. Here from the extreme position is P, that we can take from extreme position towards mean position, it travels a distance A by 5. And what must be the remaining distance? It must be 4A by 5. As a result, the radius of the reference circle to be considered it as an amplitude. We all know, because this is the relation between uniform circular motion and simple harmonic motion. Here we all know the relation between uniform circular motion with a simple harmonic motion as, what is that? Here the particle, the particle executes uniform circular motion, its projection along the diameter of the reference circle, it executes a simple harmonic motion. You all know this. Therefore, I made it as a part. As the P moves from one of its extreme position to the distance A by 5, the remaining distance will be 4A by 5. And by constructing the right-angled triangle for this, here A will be the radius, that is the amplitude, and the adjacent side, that we can take it as 4A by 5, and opposite side will be the remaining part. Now we have the relation between, that is the A cos theta or cos theta. Here in the triangle, cos theta can be equated to adjacent by hypotenuse. The adjacent side is 4A by 5 and the hypotenuse side is capital A. That is 4A by 5, capital A, can be equated to 4 by 5. Here it is cos theta. Now theta can be equated to cos inverse of 4 by 5. And we know that the angular theta is now angular displacement, and this angular displacement can be taken as omega t, because we know that angular velocity can be given by angular displacement by time taken. Therefore, angular displacement can be equated to the product of angular velocity and the time. This can be equated to cos inverse of 4 by 5. Now, just the simplification terms remain. The time t can be equated to 1 by omega. That means this omega, you can bring it in the denominator of the right-hand side part, 1 by omega. Cos inverse of 4 by 5, that is equal to capital T divided by 2 pi. This term we can bring by substituting omega value, because omega value is equal to 2 pi by capital T. That means 2 pi by time period. And this denominator of the denominator capital T, you can bring it in numerator T, that is T by 2 pi into cos inverse of 4 by 5. So this is the correct option. The option number B is the correct option. Question number 13. A particle undergoes simple harmonic motion with a time period of 2 seconds. In how much time will it travel from its mean position to a displacement equal to half of its amplitude? 1 by 2 seconds, 1 by 3 seconds, 1 by 4 seconds, and 1 by 6 seconds. And here the displacement that we can consider, it has a x direction, that x equal to a sine omega t, that omega value we can substitute 2 pi by capital T into t. Therefore, for x equal to a by 2, because it is given in the question, in how much time will it travel from its mean position to displacement equal to its half of the amplitude? Therefore, we have taken x value as a by 2. Now, that x value as a by 2, you can substitute. both the A terms you can make cancel in the equation. Therefore, 1 by 2 can be equated to sine 2 pi by 2 into t. Now, again, here in the sine 2 pi by 2, because here capital T value already it is given as 2 seconds. Therefore, in the place of capital T, I have substituted it as a 2. Therefore, sine pi t can be equated to 1 by 2 now. Now, we can have for what angle we will get the value as what angle of sine we will get the value as half. We know that is sine 30 will be equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, the sine inverse of half will be equal to pi by 6. Therefore, pi t can be equated to pi by 6. Therefore, the value of t or the time period t equal to 1 by 6 seconds. Next question. The phase difference between two simple harmonic motions y1 is equal to 10 sine 10 pi t plus pi by 3 and y2 equal to 12 sine 8 pi t plus pi by 4 at t equal to 0.5 seconds is a equal to 11 pi by 12 and b equal to 13 pi by 12, c equal to pi, and d option is 17 pi by 12. Here it is asking about the phase difference between the two SHMs. So here displacements are given in the y directions. Now our job is to determine the phase differences. Now we can consider the phase of the first particle. The phase for the first particle executing SHM is phi 1 equal to 10 pi t plus pi by 3. And phase of second particle executing SHM can be equated to pi 2 equal to 8 pi t plus pi by 4. That delta phi means the phase difference can be equated to phi 1 minus phi 2. If you substitute phi 1 value and phi 2 value, you will get 2 pi t plus pi by 2. And in the question, it is asked the phase difference at a time interval t equal to 0.5 seconds. That means for the time interval t equal to 0.5 seconds, if we substitute the value t equal to 0.5 seconds in the above equation, that is delta phi equal to 2 pi into 0.5 plus pi by 2, which will give you 13 pi by 12. Means delta phi is equal to 13 pi by 12. Means phase difference is 13 pi by 12. The option number B is the correct option. Next, question number 15. If displacement x and velocity v are related as 4 v square equal to 25 minus x square in a simple harmonic motion, then time period of given simple harmonic motion is, here all the units that we can consider as a standard unit, that is SI unit, and the options are given pi, 2 pi, 4 pi and 6 pi. Here we can take the equation which is given over v square equal to 25 minus x square, and by considering the function as a implicit and the differentiation for the implicit function, that can be taken it as a, suppose if we take any function which is again dependent on another function, okay, there the differentiation of that function will be taken first and differentiation of that second function, that will be considered. By implicitly, if we differentiate this function as this 4 v square equal to 25 minus x square as this 8 v, that means 4 into 2 into dv by dt, that can be equated to differentiation of any constant term will be 0 minus differentiation of this x square with respect to t again, because x is again dependent on time. Here v is again dependent on time. Therefore, we have followed this method to differentiate this equation. That is 8v dv by dt and differentiation of 25u is 0 because it is a constant term, minus of 2x because x square is 2x into dx by dt. And now we can have this term dv by dx as what? Acceleration. That means differentiation of velocity with respect to time as acceleration, that I can substitute as a small a term. That is 8v into a we can write. In the right hand side, anyhow 0 can be eliminated, minus 2x into dx by dt, differentiation of displacement with respect to time will give you the velocity. That velocity term I can represent it as a v, and I can substitute in the RHS term. That is 8v a can be equated to minus 2x v. Both the v we can make cancel, and we will get acceleration value as minus x by 4 after the simplification, because 8 we can bring it in denominator of the RHS. There you will get minus x by 4. And now again we can take the equation of acceleration of a particle executing simple harmonic motion. Here we have omega square x. That means minus omega square x can be equated to x by 4. And both the x we can make cancel on either side. Therefore, you will get omega square as 1 by 4. That means value of omega square as 1 by 4. Therefore, omega square value you can substitute. That is 2 pi by capital T whole square is 4 pi square divided by capital T square. Can be equated to 1 by 4. Now the T square will be equal to 14 pi square. You will get T square value will be equated to 16 pi square. You will get 4 multiplied by 4, 16 pi square. You will get that 16 pi square. If you take square root, you will get 4 pi seconds. It means the time period of oscillations or simple harmonic motion will be 4 seconds. Option C is the correct option.